In last 1 week period, we have seen a sharp fall in crude and natural gas prices. No doubt, crude from lower side, we have seen a sharp recovery. In November month also, we have seen crude prices rallied very well, continued to hold above $40 mark throughout the November month. And right now, WTI is very well placed above $45 mark. In last 1 month period, almost 14% rally has been seen in crude oil prices. We have seen on the hope of vaccines and manufacturing number from China has been slightly supportive. This both of these has been supported crude oil prices, and we have managed to hold above $45 mark for WTI, and Brent is nearly to test $48 to $50 mark. Overall, slight concerns is still prevailing in the market on the heat of OPEC meet, because there has been a speculation going on and market expectations are high that OPEC plus could defer this production cut. Maybe there will be no production hike as of now, then production cut will be continuing for next 3 months. That could support the crude oil prices. Overall, we expect prices are going to be in a choppy range, but with a positive bias on domestic side also. We unless and until 30-200 level doesn't break, a bounce towards 36-36.50 could be possible for crude oil. Coming on natural gas prices, we have seen almost 6% fall in natural gas prices as weather conditions are not so much supportive. No doubt, inventory data was been slightly supportive. We have seen prices moving in a broader range of 225 to 200 level mark. Today also, we are expecting that inventory can be slightly showing a built up, because of that prices could breach 200 level mark, but downside is really restricted looking to the weather condition for December month. So a drop towards 194-195 would be the good level to take long position in natural gas prices. Again, a bounce towards 215-220 is possible for next 1 week period. Overall, among energy market, already since last couple of months we have seen prices were traded with a negative bias, but now prices are under consolidation in November month. December month could be a positive trigger for crude and natural gas, both the counter. Crude, we are expecting next week 3600 to be tested, unless and until 3200 doesn't break, and natural gas, initial drop towards 94-195 would be the great level to take a long position, targeting 220 on higher side. In base metal prices, we have seen a good recovery in all counters. Volatility were been there in the market, but despite this, we have seen a great performance from copper, where on weekly basis we have seen prices gain nearly 4.5% to test almost 590 level mark. Similarly, lead and aluminium, both the counter have traded with a positive bias. On week-on-week basis, we have seen lead prices gain by 1% to test 160 level mark, whereas aluminium prices rallied very well with a gains more than 2.5%, testing almost 167 level mark. Meanwhile, nickel and zinc, already we have seen in past month prices were traded with a positive bias. Now prices are under consolidation phase. Inventory started piling up for zinc. Already we have seen from last couple of months that is creating some pressure. Maybe looking to the other base metal, zinc prices may test around 220 level. That could be a greater level to take short position looking to the inventory pile up. Prices can once again show some weakness towards 110 to 210 to almost 200 level in downside. Whereas nickel prices also, we have seen earlier in the month of August, September, October, greater demand for iron ore and stainless steel demand were been there in the market. Because of that, prices rallied very well to hold near to 1200 level mark, but multiple of time we have seen prices failed to cross 1240 level. Unless and until 1240 doesn't break, a sharp pullback towards 1120 could be possible for nickel prices. Whereas copper, we have seen dollar weakness has continuously supported copper prices. Also, the hope of vaccinations for COVID-19 has supported the sentiment for all base metal prices. Overall, we expect upside would be possible looking to the economical data point from China and other countries, but higher side technically is slightly overbought. So slightly be cautious for this week. Maybe we can see a sharp correction in base metal prices if any negative news trigger in the market. But unless and until copper holds 580 level mark, we can see a prices going towards 600-605 also. Similarly, in the same fashion, unless and until 163 doesn't break, aluminium prices can test 170 level mark, lead can test 164 level mark, but be cautious for this week. Any negative news can trigger a sharp sell-off in base metal prices. In last 1 week period, we have seen greater volatility coming back in bullion prices. We have seen gold and silver prices initially drop sharply. In international, as we have seen since last couple of weeks, we have seen gold prices were trading in a range of 1880 and 1920. On the heat of vaccinations, we have seen a sharp fall in gold prices to the tune of almost 1760 in downside. But now things have been again improving. Overall, in last 1 week period, domestic market also we have seen gold prices drop below almost 48,000 level mark, but again recovered. Right now trading 1.5% positive from the overall week on week, whereas silver prices gained nearly 6%. We have seen sharp fall in dollar index. We have seen dollar index drop below 91 level mark that has supported gold and silver. Secondly, number of cases in Europe and the US is continuously on rise. No doubt vaccine will slightly cap this gain, but overall concerns are still prevailing in the market. We have seen stimulus talks are quite high in US, and if there is any bigger package, then definitely gold would be supportive. So overall we expect gold and silver for coming week is going to be on a broader side. Volatility would be there in the market, no doubt. Year end would be there, so most probably by mid of December the volume will be started shrinking. But for this week, unless and until 1800 level mark in international doesn't break, we may see a sharp jump towards 1860 to 1880 in international market, whereas on domestic side prices holding above 49,000 is a good positive trigger. Hold above 49,000 can give us a target of 50,200 to 50,500 in next 1 week period. Coming on silver, as we have seen, Chinese manufacturing numbers and other economies numbers are quite high. Dollar weakness is being supportive. Also talk of stimulus from US and China is also been supportive. We have seen some good recovery in base metal prices that has also supported silver prices. In international, right now prices are very well placed about 2350 level mark that can go up to $25 to $25.50 in next 1 week period. On domestic side, we have already seen 6% rally in silver prices. We still expect prices are going to be on a positive side unless and until 60,000 level mark breaches. Higher side, we can see a level like 66,000 to 67,000 in next 1 week period. Overall, for next 1 week period, one should buy and hold gold and silver for an immediate target of 50,500 for gold and 67,000 for silver. Thank you.